Coco the doll. Coco the doll, who is a Atlanta transgender woman, was recently deleted a week ago, and now they have found a number one suspect, which is a 17-year-old male boy. That's in pretty much in Atlanta police custody, because the simple fact they are calling him the number one suspect of deleting Coco the doll recently. This one, I'm going to actually go in on this one, folks. But before I do so, make sure you subscribe to Kel Culture Radio. Remember, the link is pinned on top of my chat, also in the community tab, and also in my bio. Remember, we go live each and every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 6 o'clock Eastern Time. Hope to see you there. Shout out to all the new subscribers have subscribed to the page. And not only that, but is going to subscribe to the page. Hope to see you there in one of our live streams. We will greatly appreciate it. And also give you a shout out, because we like to have new people there, especially on the channel. And not only that, on the live stream, we really, really have dope conversations with my good man Prince Akeem and my good man New Jordan Era. So, hope to see you there at one of the live streams. So, Coco the doll pretty much is a transgender woman. I used to be male, but now it's a woman. Not only that, she was an advocate within the community in Atlanta. She was just recently deleted by a 17-year-old boy. Not boy, pretty much a teen. Because the simple fact of nobody really knows. Some people might say the person might have been a homophobe or probably had some sexual involvement. Nobody really know. It's all in speculation as of now. But the person is now in Atlanta police custody, and it's pretty much sad, because at the end of the day, that community, which is the LGBTQ community, they do go through a lot of heat. They get a lot of backlash, and you do have people that really do hate them and pretty much want to exterminate them. To me, I leave that community alone, because at the end of the day, they're still people, and they have the right to practice or to be whoever they want to be, because, hey, we live in a free country. Who am I to try to ridicule and to persecute them for something that they want to do? At the end of the day, they are their own decent human being, and to me, it's wrong if you're that person that's dealing with a lot of hate towards them. And not only that, I think if you have that type of hate towards them, it says something about you. Because at the end of the day, you're supposed to be one about your own life and take care of your own business. Now, I know at times there are some people that do be involved with them. And at the end of the day, when they do find out they got caught, they end up deleting that person. And not only that, there's been time where the person that is a transgender will actually play games on certain men. And then they get upset of the backlash they receive. So I understand both sides of the spectrum, but I have not yet talked to one of them, so it's kind of even hard. And probably that's why we would try to do on a recent interview with Kel Culture Radio, probably have one on the show and see what type of backlash they do receive when it comes to that when it comes to their community. Because at the end of the day, they're still people at the end of the day, and some of them are really seeking for love, but the world don't see it that way. So of course I got the audio of a news report talking about the situation that transpired with Coco the doll.
We have some breaking news just into the newsroom. Police arresting a 17-year-old who they say killed a transgender woman here in Atlanta. Jamarcus Jernigan faces several charges, including murder and aggravated assault. Atlanta police say he turned himself in yesterday. Last week, Coco, also known by her loved ones as Rashida Williams, was gunned down on Martin Luther King Jr. Drive Southwest. She was the star of the documentary Kokomo City. The teen arrested and her murder is being held in the Fulton County Jail.
Yeah, with no bail. You don't have no bail. So at the end of the day, to me, if you're someone that's dealing with that type of hate towards that community, to me, deal with yourself. Because at the end of the day, they're not messing with you. Now, if they mess with you, then I'll be like, okay, you know, do what you got to do. But if they're not messing with you and they're going about their business and you yourself deep down inside hate them, you really have to check with you. I'm just being honest. Because at the end of the day, even if they come home to you as a male, as a man, and you be like, you got to tell them straight up, you're not into that. Like, no, I'm good, homie. Yo, you know, chill. But if you, like, receive that and you do your thing with them, and at the end of the day, you want to delete them, it says something about you, then actually them. I'm just keeping it real, and I'm just keeping it in the butt. So at the end of the day, what transpired to this person was pretty much wrong, because it really don't have nothing to do. And you a 17-year-old. What in your right mind gave you that hatred towards that person? unless you have some form of involvement or you really hate yourself. Subscribe to KL Culture Radio. Remember, link is pinned on top of my chat and my community tab and also my bio. We do go live each and every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 6 o'clock Eastern Time with my good man Prince Akeem and my good man New Joint Era. Hope to see you there. I'm out. Peace.